Hi, I am Ramesh Krish. Welcome to Upskill and Refresh program of Jiojit. This weekend, I will take you through some of the creative ways of decorating your home and surroundings. I am sure it will add a splash of colors and joy to your lockdown days. Today, I am going to show you some few painting techniques of on-stroke painting, a small flower and a rose, and tie and dye painting and a small letterbox using eco-friendly paper plates. Now, I am going to show you a one-stroke painting technique. It's a flat brush. This is a flat brush with a number 8. So there are a lot of types of brushes are there. This is synthetic hair and I'm using number 8 brush. I'm using acrylic colors for this type of painting. It's a normal acrylic color. It is available in the market. So I'm taking this flat brush. So normally what we do is to take two colors and mix it, blend it in the paper. So this is a one stroke painting technique which is different. So we are taking the two colors in same brush and blend it in the brushes itself. So see how I'm blending. So you have to blend both sides actually. See, should blend it properly like this. Now we have to make a flower design. So I'm making a small, simple flower. See, hold the brush like this. Just turn it like this. Now you got a petal. Similarly, you have to draw other petals. It's a very simple technique to draw a flower. So you will get the shading effect also simultaneously because we are mixing the colors in the brush itself. So this is a flower. So this is a very simple technique. I will again show you how to load the brush. See, I'm loading half red and half white. Mix it in the palette itself like this, both sides. Again, see, if you want some lighter color, you can add some white, more white, to get more lighter effect. You can turn the paper. You do it, not necessarily need that you have to be on same position only. You can turn the paper like this. It will be very easy to draw. So you can keep on turning the paper like this. This is a very simple way of drawing a flower. So I am making a small variant of this flower. Same way, you have to load the color like this. Earlier I made like a curve. I am going little bit pointer like this. The shape has changed. See. So. This is a flat brush, synthetic brush. It will have a big, more consistency than normal brushes. See, so we can make different types of designs using this technique. So we have drawn the flower. Now we are going to draw the leaf. Now I am going to take the green color. Take a different paper or palette so that the colors doesn't mess. In between. So I'm taking green color here. Again, it's acrylic color only, fabric colors. So I'm taking green and yellow for the leaf effect. See, same way how we did the flower, I'm going to paint the leaf also. I'm taking half green, half yellow. Blend it properly like this. You can see the shading in the palette itself because we are blending the color in the brush itself, so you get the blending effect in the palette. You can see that. Just press it and turn it like this. You have to lift the brush like this. See? There are different ways of drawing a leaf. This is one of the simple techniques. Normally, we used to paint acrylic with the synthetic brush only because it will have a more smoothness and effect is there. So you have to press the brush like this and just turn it and just lift the brush so that you get the pointed effect like this. So the flowers are being scattered here and there. So what I am going to do is I am just drawing, joining these flowers with a round brush. So I am now taking a round brush. This is number 5. So I am taking again small green color in the brush. So I am going to join these flowers with a single stroke like this, single line, so that it will feel like a design. So I will show you one more small stroke with the round brush. So I am taking a number 7 brush here. Again I am taking the round brush, again I am taking green color. So here I am going to draw a small leaf. How I will draw the small leaf is like pressing the brush like this. Just see. You should draw like diagonally only, like this. It should be like 45 degree angle. You can add some yellow color, bit of yellow colors, so that you can get the shading effect. See, when we added yellow, you get a shading effect in it. So with the same flat brush itself, we can draw the same effect. I'll show you that also. Same flat brush. For this, you have to drag the brush like this, diagonally, like this. It's a little bit bigger leaf. We are using a bigger brush, so the leaf will be a little bit bigger only. So there are a lot of techniques in one-stroke painting. So I am going to draw the columns, pollen and all. For that I am just mixing a little bit of green and red to get the brown effect. So you can get brown by mixing green and red and bit of yellow. So mix few dots like this to get the decorate that center portion of the flower. Now you got a good design like this. Next I am going to show you a rose, how to paint a rose with same technique. So this is the final output. You can paint this technique in your craft items. You can paint in cloth, you can paint in kerchief. So next I am going to show you how to paint a rose. Rose is something which is very difficult to draw. Normally people think like that. Actually very simple way we can draw the rose. So I am going to show you how to paint that with rose with the one stroke painting technique. So same brush I am using, number 8, and same colors, crimson and white and sap green and lemon yellow. So same colors I have put it here. So I am using same colors only. So first I am going, we can draw in different ways. I am drawing in a freehand mode now. We can draw, we can make a trace and we can draw also. Since I am just doing it with a freehand mode now. So let's see how we can do this rose. So this is a simple technique. You have to practice it well. Everyone can do this painting in home also. It's a very simple technique, but you have to practice well. So just I'm see. Similarly, what I did earlier, I just blended the colors red and white here. So I'm going to draw the petals which is far behind the flower. See. So half red, half white. Technique is very similar. Blend it properly. The blending is very key for the painting. Here see the dark is on the bottom side and white is on the upper side. So I am drawing the petals which is coming far behind of the flower. So we have to start from back, then we have to fill the center part of the flower. So see, this is the back portion of the flower which is coming in front. So I am seeing, now I am again taking the colors white and red. You can add a bit of white because we want to add bit of more light shade the center part of the flower. So See, now we are going again, coming in the center part of the flower. I'm taking another plate for this. Actually, already the colors have been mixed and the right shade is not coming up. So I'm mixing another plate so that you'll get the right shading, right blending. It should be very important. See, the lighter shade is very important for this painting. So now we are going to the center portion of the flower. This is a petal which is a bit simple, complicated technique here. I'm just again explaining you. You have to hold the brush like this, bring it over here and turn the brush, see, and just drag like this. So you'll get the that folded effect of that flower better. So now we have drawn the rose. So for some detailing, I'm using a round brush. This is number 5. I am taking white color to have some detailing for this flower. So for the white and top portion and all, I'm just putting an outline like this to get a more detailing on the shading. So it will add some depth to the flower. That is basically why we used to draw these lines, highlighting basically, what you call. So this is a rose flower. Now I'm going to draw a bud also. So this is a very simple technique to draw the bud for rose. Again, same technique, half red, half white. Mix it properly, both sides. See how I'm going to draw the bud. Turn the brush like this. It's a small arc like shape. See, so it's a very simple technique, half red, half white. So this one stroke is normally you can paint in any object, any surface. Even furniture, you can paint in your pots, you can paint in bottles, pet bottles and all. So this is available everywhere now. So you can paint this, technique can be used in any surface. So you will get a very good effect, 3D effect, you will get it with this technique. See, you are getting, you are adding depth to the color. See, the mixing is very fine and you can add, see the depth of the each and every petal. So that is how you do the one stroke painting. So see, now I have drawn the buds also. So now we have to draw the green part, that is stems, calyx, leaves and all. So I'm going to draw the stems, calyx and all other parts of the flower. So now I'm going to draw the calyx, stems and the leaves of this flower. Same, I'm taking the number 8 flat brush, synthetic hair. Now I'm taking green and yellow, half green, half yellow. Mix it on the both sides like this properly. Now see, press the brush like this, swiggle like this, see, and drag it. Now you got the leaf effect. Press the brush like this again, see, just swiggle like this and drag it to center line. again another leaf. And turn the paper like this. You can overlap the leaf like this to get a more 3D effect like this. Again, one more leaf, bigger leaf. So we have drawn the leaves now. Now we have to draw the calyx part of the flower, buds. Half green, half yellow again. So we have blended properly. See, like this you have to draw the calyx. Simple sprout. Press it like this and just drag it like this. You can draw the stem with round brush or a flat brush. I'm using a round brush for the drawing the stem. Now we have to draw the small leaves, and to have a bouquet effect, I'm adding some small leaves. So that you get a effect of a bouquet. This leaf I have shown earlier also for the small flower. So you can see the shading effect is actually a very simple technique. You can apply in different objects, as I said earlier. So I'm going to draw some bigger leaf like this. See. Normally you can see the floral buckets and all, some effect like this. Some leaves will be like this. This is all I am doing with the flat brush only. So you can add some details with a round brush. I'm adding some green and bit of brown, red. So to draw the, add some effects in the leaf. I'm seeing, just drawing some lines over here. Can do with white color also. This is adding some effects in it to feel like a bouquet. Bit of yellow to draw the grain, pollen grains. So next I am going to show a simple technique of tie and dye. So I am using two materials. Basically we need a cloth, white cloth, a thread and acrylic colors. So we have to wet the cloth so that the color spread evenly. So what you have to do, you have to just wash it in pure water and make it wet. So I am using gloves so that my hand didn't get messy. So this is a square shape, almost a square shape cloth. So what I am going to do is, first you have to keep the cloth like this and fold it diagonally like this. Now you got a triangle shape like this. Again you have to diagonally fold like this. Why we are doing this? We want to get the center part of this cloth. That's why we are doing this technique. So now we got the center portion of this cloth. Now you can again open the foldings. Now keep it like this. Stretch it like this again. Just turn it, make it like a stick. Now take the thread. You don't have to make a knot and all. You just have to tightly, you have to just roll it like this. And make a few compartments like this. Again, bring it all here down. Another compartment like this. Another portion. So you got one session here, and another session again below. Tie it bit tight so that colors don't get spread on the other session. So I have made 1, 2, 3, and 4 sessions. I have made it here. You have to open the colors like this. Keep it open. So I am using red, yellow, blue, green, almost all the shades. You can add whatever shades you want. Here I got yellow, crimson, orange, sap green, magenta, ultramarine blue. So I am taking a round brush. See, with the brush I am applying the color. So first I am taking yellow color on the top of edge of this tie. I am using this yellow color to get a shading effect. I am adding orange color like this. So this is why I put the gloves. You have to press this like this so that the color get spread evenly. Again you have to wash the brush. Now take the another color. So I am taking the magenta, bit darker shade of red. So you should keep dark and light effect so that you'll get the exact effect of the tie and dye. So I am mixing two light and dark shade like here, like see. Earlier I used yellow and orange. I've used magenta and yellow. You can use green, bit of green. Again you can add yellow or you can add some other color. I am adding some blue so that you get a more darker effect like this. Again you have to press it properly. I am taking red color. Again I am using bit of yellow. Again you have to press it properly. So outer area we can add some dark colors. I am taking some black colors. You can add blue also, whatever color you want you can add it. Whenever you change the color you have to clean the brush properly. Now I have mixed it properly. Now gently you can remove this tie. Now I'm just opening it. You can see the beauty of tie and dye. Now this is the final output. You can use this technique in your pillow cover, your bed sheet, t-shirts, old dupattas, churidar, any surface, anything you can apply this technique. Very simple, you can try it in your home. I have not used any chemical colors and all. I just used the fabric colors, acrylic colors. So next I am going to show you a simple technique of making a letterbox in home. This is a normal plate, eco-friendly plate available in the market. Cut it into two pieces like this. Planning to draw some landscape over here. And just we'll paste it over here like with the cello tape. I have got tape also. We'll tape it and we'll paint this portion also. And we'll make it as a letterbox. So we need yellow, white, orange, red. So whatever colors is required, first take it out. First apply white in the center. clean the brush. Now take yellow. There's no separate design is required, just apply the color, central white, around that you have to put yellow color. Now take orange. I'm planning to draw a sunset, so these are the basic colors required for drawing a sunset. The edges you can draw with red color. Now we have to mix this properly to get that shading effect. See? With the flat brush, you have to spread the color. For the center part, I'm cleaning the brush so that you get some smoother effect. Mix it properly, evenly. Now we have to paint this portion also. So keep the portion like this. Now again you have to apply white, yellow, and orange, and finally red color. Now again take the flat brush. Now mix it properly like this. Now keep it aside, let it dry. Now we will give the finishing touch for this portion. I have taken burnt sienna here. So we will draw the horizon now. Draw a line like this. With burnt sienna, brown color. This is the faraway trees and hills when you see sunset. So you have to paint with brown color so that it will get a longer and depth, you can feel the depth in a brown color. Later on, we can add the darker shades. Now, take black color, add little bit of black to the brown. You will get a darker brown. The darker brown. Draw the closer part with the black and brown, that is burnt umber color you will get it. Now you can see we have drawn this this thing, and but we have not drawn the shadow of this part, so just drag these colors like this, you will get the shadow effect. Now I can take the black and brown shade, draw the details, darker line. Now we have brought the depth over here. Now we will draw with the black color some more closer portion here. See, simply draw like this. with the brush strokes, it makes a shape of grasses or something. Now draw some coconut trees over here. These are far away trees, so it should be small size. So this tree will pop up through this cover. So now we have drawn this coconut trees now. Again, we have to draw the shadow. Take a little bit of brown and black. Draw a few lines over here like this. Give the shadow of it. Now I'm going to draw a small boat over here. And this is evening and he is going back to his home. You can draw the shadow of this boat also. Now it's almost ready. Now we can come with this thing. Here we'll draw more closer object. We'll draw some land over here with black color. So make sure this portion is like this. You can see the background also. We have painted the background, so make sure it's visible over there. Now with the black color, draw the front portion. So I'm drawing some land part here. Some rocky effect, see. Draw a few fences also over here, like this. Now I'm going to draw two persons waiting for the boat to come. One small kid is also there, holding the hand of his father. So they are waiting for the boat. Now see, I'm drawing two coconut trees over here. Make sure this coconut tree have a continuation here. Yes. Now I think you get the shading a bit of that. You can see the coconut trees also as a continuation. Now what we have to do is you have to stick this together. Let it dry for some 5-10 minutes and you have to stick it together and do the rest of the touchings and staple it like this. Now it's ready. You can see I have stapled over here. Now it's the letterbox is ready. It's a very simple letterbox. You can make it in home.